Defeating a supervillain is no easy feat. A lot of these villains are stacked in terms of power, and let's not even talk about invulnerability. So today we're taking a look at some of these villains with our top 10 list of hardest villains to kill. Let's jump in. In at number 10 is the Joker. A combination of resilience, obsession, and pure insanity, the Joker has evaded death on numerous occasions, much to the Bat family's disdain. And while over the years there have been some instances in which he's kicked the can, Frank Miller's The Dark Knight Returns specifically, the majority of the time Batman's unwillingness to kill the Clown Prince of Crime has made for some of the most enjoyable conflict in comic book history. In at number 9 is Vandal Savage. Being immortal isn't easy, especially when you're using your immortality to try to plot the downfall of humankind. Vandal Savage was the leader of the Cro-Magnon blood tribe back in the days of cavemen. He came into contact with a radioactive meteorite, which gave him superhuman enhancements and immortality. Ever since, he's been screwing around with the events in history, all while trying to establish himself as the ruler of Earth. In at number 8 is Doomsday. When we were first introduced to Doomsday, he was beating the crap out of Superman, and ended up killing him, along with seemingly dying himself, which wasn't the case, but that rant is for another video. His body was attached to an asteroid and flung into space by a Superman imposter afterwards. Later to be revealed that, despite being tied to the asteroid and being in space, he was in fact alive. Known as the Destroyer, he's got regeneration abilities, capable of reactive adaptation, and is immortal. Which I guess is what you get when you use cruel evolution experiments on a baby and then clone it, ultimately trying to forge a more invulnerable superior clone of it as a means of accelerated natural evolution. Fun stuff. Up next, number 7 is Ra's al Ghul. One of the biggest supervillains in the DC universe, Ra's is a criminal mastermind who strives to create a world with a perfect environmental balance, by ridding it of most of humanity, that is. He's lived for centuries due to his Lazarus pits, which are filled with rejuvenating chemicals capable of restoring life back into the dead. He's also been killed before and then brought back, despite being cremated, all by transferring his consciousness into the body of another. And then the New 52 happened and everything was reset, so yay. Up next, number 6 is Silver Surfer. Galactus's herald, Silver Surfer has been given a tiny portion of Galactus's power cosmic, and for a long while he's searched the cosmos looking for planets for Galactus to devour. Eventually he ends up on Earth and rediscovers his humanity, causing Galactus to exile him. He's capable of quite a lot, including turning matter into energy, and the ability to absorb and manipulate the universe's ambient energy. He can see through time, and has a nearly impervious body. In at number 5 is Imperix Prime. With the goal of destroying imperfect parts of the universe and to create new perfect ones, Imperix Prime is a galactic being, who takes the form of pure energy contained inside of a humanoid set of armor. That is massive. He's been on this crusade since the dawn of time, and is almost impossible to beat, causing the forces of both good and evil on Earth to team up to save their planet. They managed to kill him with a temporal displacement weapon, thanks to Lex Luthor, sending him and Brainiac back to the Big Bang, after a slew of casualties, that is. 8 million of which were on Earth. Up next, number 4 is Parallax. Parallax is an entity made up entirely of fear, on which it feeds. It caused entire civilizations to destroy themselves out of paranoia, so as you can imagine, it is a little hard to kill. Parallax is a villain that must be overcome rather than completely eliminated, which is a feat in itself, considering how hard it is to squash fear in the first place. For years, it was imprisoned by the Guardians of the Universe in the Central Power Battery, with the Guardians keeping its true nature a secret in hopes no one would try to free Parallax. And we all know what happened when that did go down. Up next, number 3 is Apocalypse. First appearing in 1986, Apocalypse has always been a terrifying force to be reckoned with, being a class 5 mutant bent on world domination. He's got godlike abilities, which include self-molecular control, matter manipulation, augmenting or supercharging the powers of other mutants, telekinesis, shapeshifting, accelerated healing, energy manipulation, reality distortion, the ability to transfer his consciousness to another being. Oh, and he's immortal, so there's that. In at number 2 is the First. Jumping into a bit of Buffy the Vampire Slayer here, the First Evil is a malicious entity that predated man and demon alike, and is the personification of evil itself. It's non-corporeal, so it uses extreme psychological manipulation to get what it wants. It's popped up a few times in the show, the biggest occasion being the Big Bad in the final season, season 7. After the balance between good and evil is altered when Buffy is resurrected in season 6, it tries to overrun this dimension, by becoming corporeal. But luckily, Buffy and the Scoobies and all of the potential Slayers manage to defeat it and its army, destroying the Sunnydale Hellmouth in the process, rendering it powerless. And finally, in our number 1 spot is Galactus. A cosmic entity who consumes planets in order to sustain his life force, Galactus has the power cosmic at his disposal, allowing him total manipulation of energy in order to achieve almost any effect he desires. He does have a weakness though, that hunger for planets is his downfall, If he doesn't consume life force, he'll fade. But that doesn't make his power or invulnerability less immense. Jack Kirby, one of Galactus' co-creators, has stated, I quote, "I had to get something new, and for some reason I went to the Bible, and I came up with Galactus. And there I was in front of this tremendous figure, who I knew very well, because I always felt him, and I certainly couldn't treat him the same way that I would any ordinary mortal." And of course, the Silver Surfer is the Fallen Angel. They were figures that have never been used before in comics. They were above mythic figures, and of course, they were the first gods. Alright, there we have it, friends. What other villains do you think are hard to kill? Let us know in those comments below. And as always, if you dug this video, please show us some love and hit those like and subscribe buttons. And if you want more nerdy lists, why not check out our top 10 most popular video playlist on our channel. In the meantime, thanks for watching, guys. I've been Kelly Pally, and this is Top 10 Nerd. I'll catch you all in the next one.